Chris here again from Pronamics. Let's go over working with resources in expert estimation. Being a first principles estimation program, it uses the concept of base resources. So a base resource is a single unit of cost that you can't break down any smaller. So for example, an hour of labor, or a liter of petrol, or a meter of cable, or a single office chair, whatever it is you're working with. Every project has its own list of those resources used in that project to build up that project's costs.
You can access that list anytime by clicking here to open up the project's Resource Explorer. Here, we're looking at all the resources of the Wilson Creek Bridge tutorial project, which comes loaded with every new installation. And as this project is close to being finalised, all the resources are set up and have been used throughout the estimate. The grid shows all the details recorded for each individual resource. So you can see each resource's identifying details, like its name, description, unit, and of course a base rate, which is what the resource costs to use per unit. The Resource Explorer acts as the central point of truth for all the resources for this project. So if you update any of these details, like updating the base rate for example, this will update throughout this whole project. This means you can rely on using just one window to create, review, and update the resources for each project. The state column, very usefully, allows you to associate a level of confidence as to the base rate of the resource. So you can use plugged for an educated guess, unplugged when you've got something better than an educated guess, and confirmed when you're most certain, if you have a quoted price for a certain material, for example. This feature is purely a review feature. It doesn't impact on the cost of the project in any way. There are a series of rate modifier columns, including the applied factor, which allows you to easily change the rate of a resource by multiplying the base rate by a factor, and the rate adjustment column, which allows you to add or subtract a total from the base rate. The calculated rate you see here shows you the rate of the resource that will be used in calculations in the project. So this will always be the same as the base rate, unless you've applied one of the rate modifiers. You can also see useful review information like the value in project and use in project for each resource, and the date the rate was last changed for each resource, and identify the supplier or subcontractor for each resource. As with any grid, you can click on the column header of any column to sort the grid by that column. So if we sort the grid by value in project, greatest to smallest, this allows us to easily review the most significant resources in this project. The tree view here to the left shows you how the resources are broken up into five resource types: labor, material, plant, subcontract, and other. And clicking any of these folders will filter the grid for just the resources of that type. Now, while these types are fixed, you can add any number of subcategories by clicking the Add Category Subfolder button here. You can have as many levels of these as you like. This means you can organize your resources exactly how you want them organized under the five resource types. When you create your first blank project, your Resource Explorer will look like this, and you'll need to start building up your resources. You can add resources one by one quite simply by clicking the Add Resource button here in the middle of the window, or here on the ribbon toolbar. To create a resource, you'll need to specify at least a unique name and a resource type. You can also add a description, unit, a base rate, and supplier if you'd like. Click on Create, and you're done. Expert Estimation is very friendly with working with spreadsheets. So if you have some resource information in a spreadsheet, like we see here, you can save a lot of time by copy and pasting the resources into the Resource Explorer. Just keep in mind for this trick to work that each resource must have a unique name and a resource type specified, either labor, material, plant, subcontract, or other. There must also be no blank lines in the data you've selected. When pasting, you'll see the Paste Special window. This allows you to map each copied column into the best column in the Resource Explorer. So the copied columns don't have to be in any particular order to paste them in. And any columns you don't want to paste in, you can simply leave as none, and they'll be ignored. Click on Paste, and you're done. As with other windows in the program, the ribbon toolbar makes all the features discoverable, like cloning a resource, useful when you need to create a new resource similar to an existing one, and substituting resources, which allows you to instantly replace one or multiple resources used in your project with another, and so on. You can use the copy and paste buttons here to copy and paste resources among projects, or easier still, use the right mouse button to click, drag, and drop resources between resource explorers. You can also set up linked projects to speed up the resource sharing process.
And that's working with resources. In the next video, we'll go over setting up the direct and overhead cost schedule so we can apply those resources. If you'd like more details about resources, check out the links that we've put below this video to relevant articles in our knowledge base. And of course, you can always speak to me or any of our 24/7 support team in our Brisbane office on our support number. And leave us a comment below. I promise we'll read every single one.